One of the most emotional days of the year when an ACC team takes on Florida State. And amidst the fireworks, here comes the Wolfpack. The Pack taking the field just moments ago. And now live, you look at Carter Finley Stadium. Tim, we mentioned the high-powered offenses. This is what these two teams did a year ago.
Keep in mind, a lot of that was Torrey Holt, though, for NC State. It was late in the game. They have to prove they can do it early, and they have to do that today.
And there is a look at Mike O'Kane. And now Bobby Bowden, 11 straight years in the top four, 10 wins throughout that time. 47-1, only one loss. That's to Virginia back in 95 since they joined the ACC. Six straight ACC titles. He's going after his seventh. But obviously, anytime the Noles take the field in a given season, they're looking at national championship aspirations.
Sure, and his problem is different than that of Mike O'Kane. Mike O'Kane is trying to raise the level of his players to compete with Florida State. Bobby Bowden's problem is to keep his players mentally honed because they're going after a national title and certainly are heavily favored in this game.
Now, Bobby Bowden's squad will receive the opening kickoff. North Carolina State won the toss, deferred to the second half. And right away, Mike O'Kane making a decision to get his defense on the field. But he gets his defense on the field against that Florida State offense. That's the bad news.
Yeah, and I'm not sure that's a good call, and I'll tell you why. I like to put the offense on the field when you're outmanned like they are today and try to melt as much of the clock as you can and keep their high-powered offense on the sideline.
The Wolfpack, losers last year in Tallahassee, 48-35, but they gained a lot of confidence from that comeback, if you will, and have not lost since. Scott Earwood, the first kicker since 1957 in an NC State uniform to handle the kickoff duties, the place-kicking duties, and the punting duties.
Boy, you just hate to give a knockout puncher the first shot, and that's what they're doing here.
And back deep, you look at Dee Feaster. Great running back. He'll get a lot of time in the backfield today because Bobby Bowden wants to sub for Travis Miner. He's back there along with Reggie Durden, a junior out of Houston. And we're underway in Raleigh. It'll be Feaster at his own 7-yard line. Got a hole up the middle. Closes quickly and out to the 26-yard line. That's where the Noles will start their first series. The chilly starting lineup, the offensive line for Florida State, it's a young one, but this is the biggest offensive line Bobby Bowden has ever had at Florida State. They go about 6'5", 300 pounds. The wideouts, Ron Dugan's getting a start today. And yep, there you see him. Peter Warwick with a bad ankle, bad foot, but he is in the starting lineup. Lamar Glenn, the fullback, one of the keys for Florida State in that win over Texas A&M. And Travis Miner with a record 34 carries. That's a Florida State record. Goes down, Winky. Play action. Plenty of time, and he's got Warwick wide open over the middle of the football field. Can you believe this? On the first play from scrimmage, Warwick to the end zone.
Let me say it again. You don't want to give a knockout puncher the first shot.
I believe you're right, partner.
74 yards. The ankle, the foot are fine. And he is definitely in the Heisman race.
Earlier in the week, Peter Warwick on crutches after the injury against Texas A&M. No crutches there. Wow. Sebastian Janikowski on for the extra point. And he blasted through all the way back to the NC State band. So one play, one touchdown for Peter Warwick in the Noles.
Didn't look like a complicated route either. He just ran a post pattern. I think there was confusion on the defensive side, but I want you to watch this. The left hand to your screen. It's a play action. Everybody sucks up. Now he looks down to the right. There he is, just splitting the zone, and he's wide open. There's nobody in a red jersey even around him. Touchdown Warwick. Jason Perry, I guess, was the closest. He was the safety, but look at this. He just runs in the seam, and Wanky just throws it perfectly. Now, Chris Wanky, you know, there were some question marks about him early, saying he's not as experienced as they'd like. I want to tell you something. They said he made all the right reads in the kickoff classic, and he comes out in this game, and he's one for one.
You know, he had that smile on his face yesterday, though, when they talked to him at the walkthrough. Said, yeah, I kind of played it close to the vest in the Texas A&M game. Got it to Warwick a couple of times, in fact, nine times. Had a great day, did Warwick. But we really didn't have the big play. We want to open it up against NC State. I think they did that early enough.
What amazes me is I know the defense for NC State did not want to get in one-on-one coverage, cover one, and they were trying to run some combination defenses all day so they can help each other. But this is amazing to me. You see the Heisman Trophy come out and line up by himself and just runs a post pattern and he goes untouched.
So the worst possible thing that could have happened for Mike O'Kane. You win the toss, you defer to the second half, you kick off to Florida State. I guess the worst thing that could have happened is Florida State would have run the kickoff back, but this is just as bad.
Mike is such a good guy, and he's an outstanding coach. Boy, it's tough when you have to take it on the chin right away to start.
Janikowski, yeah, he goes about 255 pounds. From Poland, came over at the age of 15, now from Daytona Beach.
And that's a solid 255.
He is a load.
He's got that bald head and that big body, looks like a linebacker.
Eric Leek, left of your picture, and Rashawn Spikes, starting tailback, set to return this kickoff from the nose. Here's the surprise. Janikowski sends it 6 yards deep to the end zone. And Leek will go to one knee, bring it out to the 20-yard line to start their first set of downs. The Chili's starting lineups for NC State. This offensive line, a couple of returning starters. Ian Rafferty coming off knee surgery, really the leader at the left tackle spot. Justin Burroughs scored a touchdown on a recovered fumble last week against Ohio. Not only do you know about Torrey Holt, who has either broken all the records or will break the NC State records, but Chris Coleman, a reliable receiver when all the attention is on Holt. And in the backfield, Rashawn Spikes takes over for Tremaine Stevens, one of the outstanding runners in NC State history.
Yeah, Stevens ran for 1,142 yards. Spikes has to pick up that pace a little bit, help him out back there.
Well, Jamie Barnett now, out of the shotgun, goes back under center and directs Spikes and the fullback Jeff Butler to get in the eye. Spikes, big hole up the middle, and a big game for the Wolfpack. Across the 40 and out to the 48-yard line. Spikes ahead for 28 on NC State's first play from scrimmage.
Give a lot of credit to Barnett, the quarterback, because he checked it in. They spread the offense, would spread the defense thin. They didn't have eight guys in the box. If you stop it right there, you look at all this territory he has to run. They did that because they spread it. They got the linebackers out of there from tackle to tackle. They spread it thin, opened up that hole. He got into the secondary and had the big gainer.
Well, it's a Florida State defense that is banged up this early in the year. They've got a number of players, and we'll talk about that later on, who are not playing today.
Ryan Hamrick didn't get off the field fast enough, and Barnett called a timeout to avoid a penalty.
So a timeout on the field. NC State wants to set things up and get organized, and we'll take one as well. The Noles up by a touchdown. The Wolfpack driving. Well, if you went to get a soda moments ago, you missed the score already. 74 yards. Peter Warrick on the first play from scrimmage from Chris Wenke. But Jamie Barnett, one of the best seasons in NC State history as a quarterback a year ago, and set to break most of the records for the Wolfpack. Only a junior, he's been a starter for 2.5 years. In motion is Holt. Barnett with a straight drop. Has time, but this one is deflected over the middle. Demetrios Stevens, the senior, got a hand on it. And this is a defense for Florida State that Bobby Bowden calls maybe the fastest he's ever had. Up front, they are injured, though. Larry Smith out with an ankle injury, so Corey Simon getting a start. Demetrios Stevens taking over for four-year starter Darryl Bush. Stevens calling the signals defensively. Theon Rackley getting a start as well. And this may be the deepest secondary that Bowden has had, too. They're very quick back there, and you know revenge is on their mind. Corey Holt with the 5 touchdown catches a year ago. Second and 10, Barnett. Quick out, there's Holt. He can do some damage when he catches the football. Inside the 35 to the 33-yard line. Corey Holt with his first catch of the afternoon in a big game for the Pack.
Now they put him in motion. They put him in the slot, this time way out wide. Now watch this. It's just going to be a little hitch. Flanker screen, bring him back in. Hope you get some blocking. Break a couple of tackles and he's got the first down. I'm telling you folks, he is special. Senior captain, legitimate All-American. Caught 16 touchdowns last year. That's a career for most guys.
One-on-one with Troy Saunders, Tim, who had some troubles in the Texas A&M game. And don't be surprised if you see Mario Edwards in there fairly soon. First down for the Pack. Spike, got room on the left side. inside the 30, down to the 27-yard line. So the Pack moving the football on their first drive. Dexter Jackson, the free safety senior out of Quincy, Florida, on the stop.
All right, here you go now. You talked about the defense as we look at Spike. All right, two carries for NC State, 34 total yards. That's already more than Texas A&M was able to run against this defense in the kickoff class. Texas A&M got only 33 yards all night.
Rashawn Spikes with the two carries so far for the Pack. Spikes much more of an inside runner than Stevens was a year ago. That's more powerful. Garnett under pressure. This one's almost picked off. From the outside, Seymour.
Yeah, he was going to Holt again. Holt was just running a little short post pattern. But I want to tell you something. See, now you've got Stevens in there, who's a great big guy. He's 6'3", 240 pounds, and he's got a great big wingspan. Now Barnett goes to throw. Stevens stands. Boom. I mean, they just come hard. Everywhere around that football, they're running and hitting. Controversy this week because Michael Kane said they are aggressive, they play fair, but they really play on the edge. And a big headline said he was worried about their safety. I want to say I'm worried about their safety.
But it harkens back to the days of Bruce Sterling with all the comments about Florida State knocking out quarterbacks. Barnett to the turf again after the incomplete pass. And Michael Kane, we talked to him about this too. And
he was very sensitive.
He was upset about the way the article came off in the papers, because he said, I wasn't making any commentary at all about Florida State going after people and trying to hurt people. I said they tried to take out Torrey Holt, as in doubling him and taking him out of the game. And he said, I'd like my players to play like Florida State's players on the edge all the time.
Well, and it became a big issue because of the bowl when Steve Spurrier was talking about them hitting late and playing on the edge and actually crossing the edge. Michael Kane was so upset by the headline, he actually called Bobby Bowden and said, hey, look, coach, this is what I said. I said, I love the way you guys play. You play on the edge, you play aggressively, and I wish my guys would play there.
Now, if you're Florida State coach or a fan, all you're thinking is, here we go again. Same type comment that Steve Spurrier made, and we're sick of it. Well, Alex Santos, and this left guard.
This is going to be a problem today for NC State because they are not very deep on the offensive line.
Santos, a senior out of Orlando, that left leg that he's favoring. They've got a number of players out already on that offensive line. As you said, Todd Boyle, a tackle, out with a neck and shoulder nerve injury. And now Mike O'Kane going to place it down and try for a 44-yard field goal. Here it is. And this one is well to the right. And no good. Irwin with his first try of the year, the transfer from Catawba College, not successful. Well, the no, still up by a touchdown.
Hey.
ABC Sports presentation of college football brought to you by Genuine Chevrolet, the cars more Americans trust. The Home Depot, America's home improvement coach. National Car Rental. So what are you waiting for? Let's go. And Chili's, a proud sponsor of ABC College Football. Gorgeous day in Raleigh, North Carolina. Some of Tim Brandt's buddies in the stands watching on. 7-0 Seminole. Chris Wanky going to take over at the 27-yard line. First and 10, Knoll.
Marvin Minnis in for Warren on this series.
Glenn and Miner out of the eye. Play action again. Wanky throws, got minutes, comes back. Nice catch at the 45-yard line. Now they rule it incomplete. A little bit underthrown, and they'll bring it back. And let's check in right now with our New York studio and John Sunder.
It's time for the Burger King update. Trouble in Ann Arbor for the Wolverines coming off that loss to Notre Dame. Kevin Johnson here, 6 yards on the touchdown run. Donovan McNabb has now just thrown a touchdown pass to Conrad. And it's a 13-0 game. The extra points still to come. We'll keep you up to date. Terry, back to you.
Still trying to get over that loss to the Irish, I guess, John. And, of course, later tonight, Notre Dame in action against Michigan State in East Lansing. That right here on ABC at 8 o'clock Eastern. An incomplete pass on the first play. Wanky going deep. He's got Cole, the other speedster. huge gain inside the 20. Finally brought down at the 11-yard line. Harrison had the initial coverage, but it was Tony Scott who finally ran down Lavernius Cole.
No question, when he tells you wide receiver is the strength of his offense, loaded with speed and depth, there's a great indication. They bring in minutes for Warwick, then they bring in Lavernius Cole for Dugan, and they don't lose anything. Watch this, it's the same pattern that Warwick scored on earlier. It's just line up wide right, then run the post pattern. Again, they were in a three-deep zone-type defense, and they just couldn't catch him.
Same play, different number. 63-yard pass that time. Travis Minor, tough going up the middle. Host of tacklers just inside the 10.
You know, for a few seasons after Tamara Vanover left school, FSU struggled to find a wide receiver with speed. Now they're loaded with them everywhere. See, look at this.
Well, you look at the speed compared to the NFL speed from the combines a year ago. Faster at the quarterback spot, a little slower at the offensive line, but look at the wideouts. Much faster than those in the NFL. The average speed in the NFL is, as we said, probably the fastest team that Bobby Bowden has ever had.
So, and if you listen to Bobby Bowden, he'll tell you he's got a couple guys that are under 4.2,
which is incredible.
That's incredible.
Now, they do run their 40s on a track in short, so it's not in pads, it's not on grass, but still, if you run anywhere in the vicinity of 4.2, if you run under, it's incredible.
Yeah, I was going to say that he also said for a while they had a trouble finding the speed receivers. And when Vanover left, they struggled a little bit, but no longer. I mean, E.G. Green is gone, but Warren, Cole, who are the fastest tandem in the country. You had Stringer, Middleton, Dugan. Man, it's a track meet.
Third and four. Play action against Wilkie in plenty of time. Thrown and picked off. Picked off by the Wolfpack. Lloyd Harrison, the junior out of Floral Park, New York, comes up with the biggest play of the game so far for the Pack.
Just sits in the end zone and waits. Here's Winky, who told us yesterday he's got to be patient because he has so much more time playing against teams like this than he does going against his own defense. But then just throws in the corner. Harrison was there just waiting. That was just a poor pass by Winky.
A lot of pressure from Greg Derrick on the outside, too. Eventually, he had plenty of time initially, though. That wasn't the pressure that caused that interception. All of last year, Tim, NC State had 8 interceptions. It was one of the priorities for them in the offseason. Already this year, they've had 4.
You know, I'm going to say, I think the problem there was he had too much time, and he just locked on the receiver and led Harrison to his throw.
Winky going to talk to Mark Rick, the offensive coordinator, upstairs now. And this is what NC State had hoped for, that Winky would make a mistake early in the game. All the different defenses that they're going to throw at him in the different coverages. And they're hoping that they can complete it. Second down and 9 after the carry by Barnett. Right flush, right at the line of scrimmage, going nowhere. Big old number 56, Roland Seymour, the sophomore out of New Orleans, met Sykes at the line and drilled it.
The NC State's caught in a tough spot down here. Number one, you're backed up against a ferocious defense. You don't want to make a mistake here. So, do you do that, or do you try to get some punting room? Well, I'd go ahead and take a shot. I mean, you're a big underdog in this game. You got Troy Holt. You got some guys you can throw. I throw a high percentage pass, maybe a quick slant to Holt, maybe the tight end.
Awfully thin on that offensive line, though. You know the Bulls are coming after you.
Well, Barnett's going to take another timeout.
That's the second timeout that Barnett has had to burn. They had to call a timeout earlier when Eric Leek wasn't in position. And now you can see Jamie Barnett awfully frustrated because something didn't look right at the line.
Well, Barnett, he's got to realize he's got plenty of room back there to move around in the end zone. He just cannot take a sack and can't throw the pick. He's got to be certain. So, in other words, he's got to throw in rhythm. He's got to go 1, 2, 3, boy, get the ball out, make sure you don't throw an interception.
So they'll talk this over on the sideline. While we have a moment, let's check in once again with our New York studio. Third down coming up for the Wolfpack. And there's Mickey Andrews for 15 years on the sidelines, the defensive coordinator and the architect of this defense.
He likes them to be aggressive. They're going to be coming after Barnett right here.
Corey Holt in motion to the far side. Three receivers set. The Seminoles may have to cross. Barnett under pressure, going to scramble with room.
Everybody stop.
Got the first down, and you're right. After the Noles defenders jumped across, everyone was in slow motion.
So the question that begs, had the play started? If the play started, that's a free shot by Barnett. If not, they'll call it back. Watch this. Everybody just stops now. If Barnett did that on purpose, that's a great play because everybody stopped with him, and then he got out and got the first down. Tay Cody made the tackle and knocked him out of bounds. Let's see who jumped first.
He's got two fouls on the play. He's got illegal motion on the offense. He's got offside on the defense. Those penalties offset will replay third down.
All right, there's Holt up top, cuts up field too early. See before the ball is snapped up here? And so, and then the bottom right, of course, yeah, two or three guys jump, but at first, it was right down the bottom with Tony Bryant.
That's a bad break for Mike O'Kane because we saw the defenders offside, and I think he thought he had a free play at that point. So it'll bring up third and nine again. And there's Holt. You know, the secondary keeping an eye on him no matter where he goes today. They go in motion. Barnett got him over the middle. Got a first down and more out to the 23-yard line. Holt with another catch, another big gain, and the Pack able to move the football early in the first. That's a 20-yard gain.
Holt started on the left side, went in motion. When he did, he took two defenders with him. The tight end, Devon Smith, was wide open, but Barnett never even looked at him. Instead, he went right here. Still a good call anytime you can go to your All-American, and he put the ball right there for it. So they moved the chains. That's a huge play for Barnett, and it's a good sign for State that they're not playing conservatively. Even backed up like that, they went on third down, threw the ball effectively rather than just worried about getting some room to punt it out.
Ryan Hamrick, Jr. out of Shelby, North Carolina, in for Torrey Holt. He gets the rest right now. Here's Chris Coleman going up for it. Who came down with it?
He got it. That's the catch.
Coleman comes down with it between two defenders. And another big gain for the Wolfpack. If they both come down with the football, it goes to the receiver. 31 yards on the catch.
Yeah, but I want you to watch this. He had it all the way anyway. Went up, split the two defenders. Nice play by Barnett on the play action. They just kind of lost it. He's got a tall receiver who's 6'3", going up against a 5'11 and 6-footer. And look, see, the ball's on his chest. They don't start wrestling away until he's on the ground.
First and 10 for the Wolfpack. Sean spikes over the right side and down to the 41-yard line. Lamont Green involved in the tackle, the senior out of Miami. Playing with the knee bruise, and we mentioned a number of players for this Florida State defense banged up. Tommy Polly has a hamstring, and we have not seen him. Brian Allen, a backup middle linebacker, out with an ankle injury. So you'll see a lot of Theon Rockley and a lot of Bradley Jennings today. And, of course, Larry Smith, the nose guard, also out with an injured ankle.
Yes, he did move the ball effectively against Florida State.
So I get this play off. Just does. Spike straight ahead and down to the 37-yard line before Tony Bryant wrapped him up. Well, Spikes, you're getting a good look at what type runner Rashawn Spikes is. The junior out of Meriden, Connecticut, straight ahead runner. Goes about 5'11", 210. Already with five carries, 41 yards, and a great average so far. But he doesn't want to go out and break him on the outside. He wants to run straight at you.
Perry, NC State had seven plays in the first drive. They already have six in this drive, so they're melting the clock a little bit, keeping that Florida State offense on the bench.
There goes Holt in motion again. Barnett with time. He's got Torrey Holt. Inside the 30 to the 27. So the Barnett to Holt combo alive and well today. It's Carter Finley. Levon Thomas, the right cornerback, was right with Torrey Holt and made the stop.
He is such a quality receiver. He's got great speed. Look, he's in motion trying to lose him. He's got the safety trailing him, does the quick out. Now look, Barnett puts the ball out in front of him. He makes a great catch. He's got three catches for 50 yards and truly looks like the All-American they said he is.
Going to get a rush at least for one play now. Seven play drive once again, as they did on the opening drive. Eric Leak in motion. Barnett flipped, and then down he goes in the backfield. Corey Simon, the junior out of Pompano Beach, Florida, got to him.
Every time Barnett does that, though, you know there's a deep breath taken on the sideline. He's playing with a bad knee. He was injured in a pickup game, a passing game, pickup sandlot game. He had his knee scoped. It's still not 100% according to some people, but I'll tell you what, he looks 100% to me. He's wearing that big knee brace. You can see that right there on his MCL.
Tore the MCL and really wasn't effective against Ohio in the first game, although they played in the midst of Hurricane Earl. 8 for 18 as the Pack barely beat Ohio. Fights on the right side. Hit hard at the 31-yard line and stopped. That'll bring up third down. The holes close so quickly with this Florida State defense. You think you have some daylight, and then all of a sudden it's gone.
Florida State is going to its speed defense, its nickel package. They've got Sean Key in the game as an extra defensive back. Expecting pass out of NC State on third and long.
Brings up third and 14.
This time Holt is in the slot.
Can he get to the end zone? Yes. Touchdown, Wolfpack. 31 yards to Eric Leak, the sophomore out of Forest Hills, North Carolina.
Looking left all the way because they had Holt there as the second receiver. So this time they bring Leak. And they send him out away from Holt. Holt took the two defensive backs inside. He cut outside, caught the pass and touchdown. They used Holt that time as a decoy.
Got Irwin on for the extra point. And he pulls it to the left.
So he's missed a field goal and missed an extra point. Michael Kane isn't happy.
But a 99-yard drive for the Wolfpack. They were backed up, had third and nine. Barnett got a first down. To a halt, and then they put seven on the board.
It's a touchdown play, and here's Holt, the All-American. Here's Leak. Now, when he runs like that, everybody's going that way, rolling. And you're going to see they use him almost as a decoy. Everybody's following Holt. Go to the backside. There's Leak, left all alone. Touchdown, NC State. All-American with or without the ball.
And Jamie Barnett so far, even though he's gone down one time, getting some pretty good protection from that offensive line. A 99-yard drive for the Wolfpack on 10 plays. That followed up a 7-play drive, which ended up with Wood missing a field goal. And he missed the extra point, so it's 7-6. Back deep, deep booster, Herbernius Cole. Cole at his own 9-yard line, going to bring it back across the field. Thrown all over the place, and Holt goes down at the 22-yard line. Three separate flags, two at the 20, one out at the 29-yard line.
One was a block in the back against Florida State.
Then Waldrop made the tackle for NC State, but we'll sort this out.
We have two fouls on the play, holding on the offense. We also have another holding on the offense. We're going to force 10 yards from the start of foul, first half.
Well, Bobby Bowden's club is one that does take a lot of penalties. Now, last year, they were penalized more than any other in the ACC, but he doesn't mind that. Look at the total yards. NC State with the two drives. Now, more than Florida State, who had two quick hitters. But Bobby says, we make penalties, yeah, but we make a lot of things happen. And they run that no-huddle offense. Doesn't bother him at all. Dee Feaster now in at tailback for Travis Miner, who gets his first break of the afternoon. First and 10 at the 11-yard line. And Winky wants to change things at the line.
Plenty of time. Play clock at 10.
Feaster going to try to get outside. Harrison had a shot at him, but couldn't wrap him up. And D. Feaster made the most of things. Got all of that at his own, as a matter of fact, out to the 23 and an old first down.
Talking with Bobby Bowden this weekend, Mark Ricks, he says, you know, he says, we're going to give more responsibility to Chris Wanky. We're going to let him make more check with me at the line and check into things, because last week, looking at the film against Texas A&M, we stayed fairly conservative, said, but Wanky was 100%. Everyone where he changed, it was the right call. So they said, we're going to give him more responsibility, and you saw him checking out of a play right there.
Thad Busby watching somewhere saying, why didn't I get that responsibility and freedom when I started out? Wanky's given much more to start his career. Overthrows Coles this time. It was well covered by Harrison. So when you're 26 years old, you and I spent time with him yesterday down on the field. There's just a confidence and a maturity that comes across with Wanky.
Oh, I guess there's no question about that. I mean, he had that career, you know, in baseball, and then finally came back to college, and right now he's older than 10 NFL starters.
Who were 4-6 last year combined, actually, in the NFL. But that's, it is amazing.
But he's a smart guy. He's huge, and a draft pick waiting to happen.
Really good game, but then he's drilled. Jason Perry, the free safety, got there and had some fun at the end of the play. So Feaster getting the playing time early for Travis Miner, who had 34 carries, as we mentioned, in the kickoff class.
See, the game that Miner had against Texas A&M in the kickoff classic, Feaster had 5 carries, no yards, and then the other guys didn't even touch it.
There's Travis on the sideline, waiting to get back in. So 3rd and 5, Wanky out of the shotgun, going to swing out of the backfield. Feaster not going to get there. Brought down at the 27. And that'll bring up 4th down for the Noles.
Good pressure that time by Greg Derrick, too. He got his big hands up there. He's 6'6 and has a big wide span. They don't think they're going to get a lot of sacks, but they do want to change what Wanky's doing. Look at number 3, get that hand up in the air. Makes him throw a little bit behind him, which slows him up a little bit.
So it brings up 4th and 6. Keith Cottrell, the sophomore who started last year. There's Torrey Holt back at his own 28-yard line. Special teams, one of the strengths of this Florida State team run. Good punt. Holt going to come up to the 32. Doesn't call for the first touch, and a flag is thrown. Still on his feet is Torrey Holt. Going to cut it back. Holt inside the 20. To the corner of the end zone. He's going to score.
He's phenomenal. And I think the penalty is against Florida State for being in the 2-yard circle. They didn't give him enough room to carry it.
Well, wait and see, but I think you're right. There was a man within the 2-yard restricted area. Holt brought it all the way back.
I don't know. There were some blockers down there that were fooling around, too. Let's wait and see. I think they encroached on it.
From the postman on the 2-yard belt, the penalty is refused for a touchdown.
Encroachment of the 2-yard belt. Folks, that guy right there is terrific.
68 yards on the punt return for Torrey Holt. That's as good a punt return as you're ever going to see. Take another look.
All right, first of all, you can see they're in the 2-yard circle right there. All right, he catches it anyway. No fair catch. Now watch the balance he has and the vision that he has as well. Gets to the outside and takes it all the way to the end zone.
And we'll take another look at that for the Wolfpack setting up for the extra point. Now remember, Earwood missed the first one. No, no problem with that. 13-7. Well, big plays, big days. That's the slogan for NC State this year. And Mike O'Kane talked about the difference in his club early last year when they didn't get big plays, and now they're getting them.
But watch his balance and watch his vision. Look at him cutting back. Here's the balance. He breaks the tackle, shows his strength. Now here is his vision. He sees the blocker, tries to get him, knows he's being chased down from behind, tries to stiff arm him, and then just says, I'll outrun him.
Derek Gibson, the man who initially missed the tackle. He should have wrapped him up. And that's the man who was closest to Torrey Holt when he got to the end zone.
Torrey Holt, All-American, 6'2", 190 pounds. Considered leaving for the NFL to stay for days like this.
His mother passed away a couple of years ago, right around Christmas time. And he's dedicated his career since then to her. Wants to open up a window cleaning business and a barber shop eventually.
I think that'll have to wait.
He's got a
career in the NFL.
Until after his days on Sunday.
Oh, you said both teams score a lot of points. I said I hope that would be the case. It'd be fun to watch. So far, it's been fun.
Hasn't been bad so far, has it? Feaster, along with Cole, I believe, back deep for Florida State. Actually, that's Jordan. He's going to take it at the 12. Straight up the cut, up to the 25. And this is a fired-up Wolfpack crowd and team at this point.
But you have to remember, it is still very, very early.
Well, these fans getting caught up in that euphoria, but I'll guarantee on the sidelines they're not. They know this man can get it back in a hurry. He did so on the first play of the game, the 74-yard strike to Peter Warrick, and then he went 63 yards for Lavernius Cole. There are his numbers.
You never really know, Terry, but it just seemed that Michael Keane was so comfortable and so relaxed yesterday when he was talking with him. He knew his players were prepared to start this game.
To the right. Winking with the pump fake. Warrick going up. He's wide open. Across midfield, Peter Warrick doing what he does best. Running right by a cornerback and down to the 38-yard line just like that.
Gave him a little out and up. Terrific move on Harrison, and Harrison bit. That was a big-time move right there.
How good is that? 38 yards.
Watch this.
74-yarder earlier.
Give him outside. Turn the head. Boom. You got Harrison beaten. His motto is, if we're even, I'm leaving. And he went right behind him and got into the secondary and made the catch. Very nicely done.
And Wanky had all the time in the world to make a decision and make the throw. Still 2:45 and counting left in this first quarter. Miner back in for Feaster. Back to the line of scrimmage. That's about it. Clayton Simon, the senior out of Hickory, North Carolina, in there to hit him. It was the defense for NC State that is much maligned. They took a lot of heat in the papers this week because they gave up 361 yards on the ground to Ohio.
Yeah, but Ohio runs a triple option offense, which you don't see very much. And remember, they were ranked fourth in the nation last year in total offense.
And beat Maryland last year. Just got beat by Kansas State. That's a solid program. Lanky, quick drop. This one's picked off at a 32. Rodney Redd, and the second pick of the afternoon for the Wolfpack.
Rodney Redd was moved from cornerback to safety, so they'd have two extra cover guys here. Now they're going to try to funnel him. One plays outside, one plays inside. Redd, the safety who's playing underneath, just met his eyes all the way. Winky is not looking off receivers, and Redd just went with his eyes to the football and made the second interception of the afternoon.
Well, he was so good against A&M at making reads, and the coaches were so happy about that, but maybe some of that rookie of their jitters, but just takes a while to make those reads for a rookie, even though he is 26 years old. There's Rashawn Spikes wrapped up in the backfield by Jerry Johnson.
Well, NC State has a game plan defensively where they're trying to keep guys from covering one-on-one. They're involving other people. They're running some combination defenses and taking some risks. High risk, high reward. Well, they've got two interceptions, but they've given up some great big plays, including the touchdown, to work.
Two key turnovers, the two picks by NC State. Got the touchdown on one, stop the drive on that drive. Barnett, great drop, has time out to Coleman. Finally, run out of bounds at the 37-yard line. Demetro Stevens and a couple of other Florida State tacklers in there to run him out.
You know, one of the things they were telling Barnett at practice when we were watching him this week is the fact that Florida State comes hard. So you have to throw in rhythm. You have to throw on time. So he goes one, two, three, four, five step drop, step up and throw. He does it before the pressure gets there. If he does that all day and makes good decisions, we're going to have some success.
We're down in a long four for Mike O'Kane's offense right now. This is where the Noles come after you. Barnett, no pressure that time. That one's dropped. That was the first down for Devon Smith, the tight end, if he could have just held on to the football. The senior out of Ahoskie, North Carolina, would love to get that one back. Earwood will come on and punt it away to Deep Easter, who is a dangerous return man. Here come the Noles. Earwood just does get it off, and he got it off quickly. It's an NC State bounce inside the 15 to the 13-yard line. The break going the way of the Wolfpack right now. A 49-yard punt. And obviously no return.
That's one of those situations where Earwood was just trying to get it off quickly before the block got there. And by doing that, he pushed it down the right side, got a good bounce to it.
Earwood started out as a place kicker and then went to a punter. And it's come on. There's the offensive production so far. Look at all the plays so far, 196 for Florida State and the touchdown. But already eight plays over 20 yards. Is a big play game.
Yeah, and that's that high risk, high reward defense they're playing.
Winkie can operate out of the shotgun now. It may have a first down for the Seminoles. Nifty move to the outside and the speed getting around the corner.
Every running back in high school should watch these kids in this game, especially on the Florida State side as running backs. Spikes does it too. But, I mean, they read their blocks and they make their cuts accordingly and explode once they see the opening.
Well, Miner had a good one to learn from. Warwick Dunn back at Catholic High School in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. But in a year plus now, he's already made a name for himself. Play, going to get outside once again. And another first down for the Seminoles. So they'll move the chains. And this is what Mike O'Kane talked to you and I about. He said, we can't let them get the 5 yards, the 7 yards, the 10 yards at a clip. And pretty soon they bust off a long one.
That's twice in a row they've shut down the middle. But being the fine running back he is, he reads it, bounces outside. He got a good block from Dugan and took it up the sideline.
12 yards on the carry. They'll move the chains. 47 left until the end of the first quarter. Again, trying the left side, different results this time. He's dropped in the backfield as Bobby Cotton, the leader of the defensive front for NC State, tripped him up.
You know, Chris Winkie is an older guy, 26, but he's not that experienced. Played baseball, came back, and actually just kind of worked on the sidelines in a practice last year. But you see the two fumbles he had against Texas A&M and two interceptions today. So he's still kind of knocked the rust off from the years that he was away with the other sports.
Pressure this time and overthrows Marvin Minnick. It was open over the middle of the field, but Winkie was rushed by the pressure.
Again, NC State's game plan was to put some pressure on him. They said, we may not get the sacks, but we noticed that when he does feel pressure, he will throw the ball high at times. Now look at this. I'm telling you something. Bobby Cotton has gotten pressure. They've gotten pressure from the inside from Bryant, and that ball was high. Way outside, to use one of his terms.
William Pinnell, the redshirt freshman, applying the pressure that time. Three freshman linebackers for NC State for time in the game against Ohio. The young defense. This one dropped by Travis Miner.
But again, they were chasing Wenke, and Wenke threw it at his feet. Miner probably should have had it, but it was a tough catch because it was a poor throw.
But a tough afternoon so far for Chris Wenke.
Watch this. Again, you know, they're trying to set up the screen, so the pressure naturally is going to come. Linebacker gets in there, see? Right around the knees. Actually, had to reach back for it.
Yeah, if he catches that ball too, it slows him up. I mean, you know, the lineman ahead. So most likely the last play of the first quarter, Cottrell just gets it off. Corey Holt, who's run one back already, gonna cut it back. Holt to the 36-yard line. Pretty good field position again for the Wolfpack after the 41-yard punt by Cottrell and the 13-yard return for Corey Holt. They're fired up at Carter Finley in Raleigh. The Wolfpack ahead of the Noles, 13-7.
I know a place.
This is not a country for wimps. We invented the cowboy, the jawbreaker, and the quarterback blitz. We are rough on our cars. So get a Chevy Malibu. It'll go up to 100,000 miles.